Good morning, YouTube. James Wright at Wood by Wright did a video recently about how to tell if your brazen bit augers are worth keeping or not. So, one of the big deciding factors is how big the ears are. This one, the ears are, I have something small I can point with. The ears stick up higher than the level of the blade, the cutting edge, so it's worth keeping. The screw point is in fair condition. This one, the screw point is in much better condition. Come on, camera, focus. But the ears don't stick up above the level of the blade at the center. So this is in the no good pile. And this is in the good pile. Now you'll notice that the large one has more flutes than the small one. The small one is an Irwin pattern bit. The large one is a Jennings pattern bit. I haven't used them enough to have any definable preference between the two. Although I like the look of the Jennings pattern better. I haven't used my brace and bit since I left my position as farm manager at a living history site 22 years ago. So his video got me curious what I still had, what condition they were in. I had to make a list so I'm not on camera squinting at the names of everything. So what I've got that is in good shape are these five here, which is a number 7 made by Gilmore Special, a number 8 made by Gilmore Special, a number 9 long made by Irwin, a number 10 Irwin pattern made by G. Gilmore, and a number 10 Jennings made by G. Gilmore. Now, on the not good side, I have a number that some of them might be repairable, and I'll probably be putting up a video on trying to weld new ears onto these. But I have a number 4 Irwin made by G. Gilmore, a number 4 Jennings made by G. Gilmore, a number 5 Jennings made by Gilmore Special, a number 6 Jennings made by G. Gilmore, actually 2 number 6 Jennings made by G. Gilmore. Number 7 Jennings made by Gilmore Special, number 9 Jennings made by made by G. Gilmore, a number 14 made by the New Haven Copper Company, number 16 made by B. Bates Manufacturing, another number 16 made by Gilmore, and one that's actually not made using the old standard where, let's see if I can find one that shows it good. It is stamped with the number 9 there. Come on, camera focus. The old standard was to mark them with the number of 16ths of an inch. But this one is actually this one made by J.E. Morrison is actually marked as 3/4. Now, I also have this stubby size is not marked on it. But I believe it is a number 7 or a number 8. And it is made by Grimm. And I have a couple of adjustable bits, both of which are missing their blades, and the small one is a 1/2 to 7/8 made by Snell one. It is a Snell 1S, and the larger one is 1¾ to 3 inch, made by Greenlee. I have one that is actually a Forstner bit. The point is broken off of it. And it's an 8, which would make it a 1/2 inch. Then I have a bunch of these that I can only describe as a brad point paddle bit. If anybody knows the proper name of this type of drill bit, please leave it in the comments. I have a 1 7/8, a 1 inch, a 5/8 inch, a 1/2 inch, and a 5/16, all made by W. Kent. Those are all in usable condition. Countersinks. I have 4 countersinks. This one is a 3/4. It's made by Stanley. I have a 1/2 inch that the point is totally chewed on, and it's not marked who made it. I have a 7/16 made by W. Kent, and a 15/32 made by Rowan and Flather. And I have a fairly modern looking spade bit. That is a 1/2 inch. and I can't get it to show the logo. It is a W and B inside of a diamond. Anybody knows that manufacturer? Patent pending, made in the USA. Couple of paddle bits that actually look like they may have been made for cutting metal. And one is made, but they're both 5/8 inch. One is made by Henry Boker in Germany, and the other is made by I&H Sorby. I made a list, and I've got it saved on my phone, so when I'm at flea markets, I know what I have and what I don't. I have two of them are probably more correctly considered spoon bits. And this one is definitely a gimlet. The gimlet is marked as a number 5, made by Henry Boker. The other two are both number 8. Come on, camera, focus. That's it. Hit the camera. And its logo is an S over top of what might be an anchor. And this one is also is a number 8, and its logo is an S inside a diamond. If anybody knows who those manufacturers are, please leave it in the comments. And I have a series of twist drills. A 7/32, a quarter inch, and a 7/16, all with no maker's mark. A 5/16 made by Union Twist. A 5/16 made by GTO, which maybe this one. GTO in Galt. And the maker's mark looks like a piece of a saw blade with two points sticking up and the G and the O in those points and then the T in between them. And the 2/7/16, one is unknown manufacturer and the other is Mebro, which I was actually quite surprised at. I always thought they were a much more modern manufacturer. Then I have a selection of odds and sods. I have a coring spoon bit that is unknown manufacturer. I have, and when I worked at the log farm, the collections manager told me this is a bunghole bit used for drilling a bunghole in a wooden barrel. But it looks like it is blacksmith made. No maker's mark. I have a security screw bit made by Henry Boker. This is the sort of security screw that many German hunting knives have, securing the pommel of the knife to the tang. I have a 3/8 flat drive screwdriver that is made by Spear and Jackson. I have what appears to be a 1/2 inch nut driver, but the end of it has been cut off, and there is no maker's mark on that. Then I have 9/16 taper twist drill. Which is marked as an 18, and there is no maker's mark on that. So if anybody knows the manufacturer of any of those that I don't actually know, please leave that in the comments. And I pulled these out partially because of James's video, and partially because I'm gearing up to go out as a volunteer demonstrating blacksmith at a living history site museum two towns over. So hopefully we'll get some footage of that this year. And little addendum, as I was starting to clean up, I found two that I had three that I had shifted out of the way and put a piece of rag over top of them. This is another twist drill, 1/4 inch. The logo on it is a capital C with a capital D inside of that. And then might be a T or a hammer with another capital D overlaid on that inside of the first capital D. And this is a 5/16 with no maker's mark. Oh no, it does have a maker's mark. It is made by Morrow. And this actually looks to be blacksmith made. I have no idea what that would have been used for, except maybe accurately starting the points of screw point or brad pointed drill bits. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.